about it, squeaking?
Right about the middle lane.
Where are you, tell you what?
There you, Daniel.
Who's out there? Hello.
Hello, who's out there?
What's cooking, man? What are you doing?
Just hanging, listening to the radio.
Rajo. Which radio's that?
That's Phil. I'm on the 139.
That's an XLR? Yeah, it sounds good, Phil.
You know what I'm looking for? I'm looking for a 2980 RCI.
Yeah, why do you want that?
I don't know. I need something for the house.
Just out of
Yeah, I hear you. What's wrong with the radio you're on?
Nothing really.
Sounds like, yeah.
For backup, you got anything in mind?
No, that radio don't sound bad. That radio sounds good, man. You don't want a 2980, man. I wouldn't buy that radio. I don't know, I would get something, you know, an old classic radio. Something that ain't gonna drift, more stable, you know what I mean? I don't know, I don't like the 2980s.
Yeah, roger.
Buy an old Kenwood 440. They're about $400. You can get it for $350 to $400, and you'll have a radio that works. Yeah, buddy.
Nah, get a CB, man. Get a CB if you're gonna talk on these channels right here. That's all you need.
Get a
good CB, good receive, good AM. No problem, man. You don't even gotta unlock the clarifier if you tune up an old one. It won't move on you. You'll enjoy it, man.
Like I said,
I would, you know, if you just want a CB, or you want all the channels.
You know, but like I said, I just...
keyed on me.
Keyed for something different, you know?
Yeah, you want something with channels, or normal 40 channels, okay?
Yeah, 40 is that good. You know, I got other equipment. I got a Galaxy, and, you know, I got a 244 unit and a thing with channels in it. I talk 38, 36, and I'm happy with that, you know?
Yeah, I would sell that Galaxy, man. You could get good money for it, and it's pretty much useless on sideband, right?
Well, I have the 95T2. I tell you, it's nice for radio. It's affordable. It prep's about $1.50, but it just doesn't hold frequency. It's got the double clarifier in it. You know, it's just a pain in the butt.
Yeah, I got the mod for that if you want to unlock the fine. So then it's just like having one clarifier almost, you know. They just work together. You know, obviously one will move a little more than the other one, but it's like having one. At least your receive and transmits in the same spot, you know.
Yeah, someone said you had to go into the PLL with that or what?
No. It's a very simple mod. It's like a 5-minute mod, man. Even LP could do that.
Yeah, better one.
Yeah, well, you know, I was in there the other day and talked to...
Stop lying, LP can't do that.
...light pole by the crystal in there, and that'll keep it stabilized. I never heard of that.
Yeah, well, it helps. You know, it helps if you put that little heater on it or something, you know. But they're just not made for sideband. They put too much technology into the AM on those.
But like I said, it's just, you gotta leave it on 24/7, you can't move it. If you put it in the car, and you turn the air conditioner on, and this, that, and the other, forget about it. It's just a pain in the butt, you know?
Yeah, I know the radios. But if you unlock the phone, at least you could, you know, as you're talking to people, you could always touch it up without them even knowing, just so you keep yourself on frequency, you know? You know, they won't even know you're off if you use the clarifier, right? You just keep touching it up, you know? And that's it, because they usually start out a little bit high, and then they come down as they warm up, you know. But that radio, you know, it gets hotter when you're on the key a lot, and then if you're idling for a while, it actually cools down, and the friggin' frequency will move again. You know, that's the thing that stinks about those. Not like it warms up, and then it just stays put, you know.
Oh, yeah, if you talk on it for a while, even if you talk, like, for a minute or so, boy, that thing gets hotter. Put your hand on the heat sink in the back, it gets so
turn the ALC up too much then. Either that or took it out if it gets that hot.
Yeah, I don't know. I've had over to Bobby and Dave there a couple of times. Not happy with it, you know, and, you know, every once in a while I have it in the box. I take it out, I put it in line, you know. You know, I got to run it, like I say, I have a 35 power supply. You have to run with it, you know.
I got a couple of base stations, if you like, you know. Do you like this one, the way it sounds? I got another one that sounds like this, pretty much. I got a few of them. You know, regular 40-channel sideband base stations.
Yeah, what are you working on now?
I'm on a Uniden 40-channel base station. That's it.
Yeah, roger. Is that the same, almost the same as the BC-244?
Yeah, yeah, real close to that. Yes, it is. Except this is, look it up online. It's a Uniden Pro 810E.
All right, I'll have to look it up. 810E Pro.
Yeah, and it's in mint condition, and you hear what it sounds like, so it should sound pretty decent.
Yeah, I'll let you know. I'll look it up.
You got it, man. And then my Washington works really good, too. Weekend told me it's right on frequency, so, you know, you got to go by that.
Yeah, that will work out something, you know.
Yeah, whatever. I don't ask a fortune for my radios anyway, man. Weekend always steals them from me.
Yeah, buddy.
All right, let me go on this. I think Glenn is back in there. I got to go grab my second cup of coffee.
Oh, squeak it, too? All right, I'll catch you later.
Who are you talking to?
Glenn, you in there with your Phil. Driver or what?
I can barely hear him.
I know, the Eelis wonder. All right, I catch you guys from the mobile. You're pretty close to me, though, right?
Oh, me? Nah.
Yeah, you gotta be like maybe a mile or two.
Yeah, buddy.
Are you in Lake Grove or Stony Brook?
Lake Grove, coming down Hawkins.
Roger, on the south side there. All right, yeah, well, you're about 20 pounds.
Heading north to Middle Country, making a right, heading to Quorum.
Yep, you're almost touching the 3 on the 30. If you could put it to the 30, then the plus, then the DB after that, then I know you're close.
Shut the box off.
Yeah, that's peaking about a 9.5. Now it's about a 7, whatever you just did. Yeah, maybe that was it then. I hear you. All right, I'm going to shut this one off. And this radio's worth $80, $100. No problem, man. It's mint. You saw what it looked like. So that's what I'm going to let it go for. Yeah, power supply built in.
40 channel.
Yeah, you saw it, right? You saw it online. You know what it looks like. All right, I gotta get my boy. I'll catch you in a little bit.